Officials from government, USAID, and from partnering organizations such as the International Youth Foundation, Belfund, CARE, NSDC, Rise St. Lucia, and the St. Lucia Chamber of Commerce attended the opening ceremony. The Caribbean Youth Empowerment Program targets vulnerable youths, in particular those behind bars, and provides them with the technical, vocational, and life skills necessary for self-development.
The International Youth Foundation made a fantastic and non-regrettable choice in expanding the project to St. Lucia, and we joined 22 other countries in Latin America and the Caribbean that are currently involved in implementing the program. Included in that number are two other OECS islands, Antigua and Grenada.
The program has attracted the support of a team of collaborating agencies that are dedicated to service.
It's programs like these that underscore the commitment of the U.S. government, the Obama administration, and USAID to the Caribbean. As you all know, one of the first things that President Obama did when he first took office in 2009 was he came to the Caribbean to participate in the Summit of the Americas. And one of the initiatives he launched, one of the first initiatives he launched as president, was the Caribbean Basin Security Initiative. And this program that we're launching here today is a manifestation of that initiative. What we're also recognizing here today is really a complete partnership, and it's a full partnership, and it's more than just a partnership between two governments.
I see SLHT and Rotary and some of the other organizations around. I am sure that they are all committed to giving that support. It's a question of you making use of it. You must plug in, because if you don't, then we cannot sustain these programs, because if no use is being made, then the programs fall apart and we don't get the desired results. So half of the job is for us to do and the other half is for you to do.
We are encouraging you to get the young people, those who you know really are in need of guidance, assistance, have them come to our hub, which is going to be in a youth-friendly environment at the Gablewoods Mall.
The Assistant Administrator for USAID says his organization is looking at expanding the program. Officials share the view that the program will help to get to the root causes of crime, as law enforcement is important and essential, but insufficient in deterring criminal activity. $500,000 EC dollars has been committed to the Caribbean Youth Empowerment Program. For the DBS News World, Jason Holland Seed reporting.